Good morning. You can be seated. Kisukukiet. Good morning. We are honored to be gathered here today on the lands of the Tanaha people. I would like to welcome you all here today. This has been a memorable school year, to say the least, and I am truly happy to have all of you together here at Fernie Secondary School to celebrate your accomplishments. We have spent this year with the continuous feeling of uncertainty about what graduation events would even be possible. I am so happy that we've been able to gather here together to celebrate you and your accomplishments. Our ceremony does look a little different than normal. We usually have honored guests to speak and give words of encouragement and representatives from various scholarship donors to present awards to you. But today you just get us. However, we do have a recorded message from our school board chairperson and local trustee, Mr. Frank Lanto. So for those of you who are viewing our ceremony from home, you will see a video message. For the graduates here in the gym, I will turn your attention to the screen and we will turn the lights down. Can you turn the lights down?
Form an integral part of our curriculum. Class of 2021, you are extraordinary. You deserve extraordinary congratulations. 80 credits are required to graduate, 52 required, and 28 elective. Your student transcript should have an asterisk. You have earned COVID credits. They were required. They were not an elective. And you have also challenged the COVID process and succeeded, also worth graduation credits. You are indeed extraordinary graduates. Your community is oh so proud of you. Graduates, for each of you, this is your moment. This is your time. Graduates, you all stand tall on the shoulders of your ancestral giants. Your talents, your abilities, your gifts, and your character has been inherited from your ancestors. Our country, Canada, indigenous for Big Valley, the home of immigrants for the most part, has been about unity, diversity, and pride. Your ancestors would only expect you to leave your family, your community, and Big Valley a better place. Today, graduates, in the midst of these turbulent times of discrimination, of racism, of mistreatment, of intolerance, we seem to be losing our way. As you leave Fernie Secondary today, find that Canadian compass to rekindle and nourish the Canadian heart. It is my hope and prayer, class of 2021, that your journey may be safe, that your destination may be golden, that as one we stand, we build this land. As one we stand, we love this land. In conclusion, I would like to share with you a song recently written by an 83-year-old Ellis Craig, a retirement home resident. And don't forget to put this asterisk at the end of your transcript. Enjoy your journey.
Came from the beginning, shrouded mists of time and space, and in this vast and northern clime, each found our sacred place. We were the first to touch this earth, the people of the land. We lit the flame and then became the first Canadians. We came on ships across the sea, found others here before. Push frontiers 300 years, a new world to explore. From sea to sea to Arctic sea, found how far we extend. We blazed the trails and laid the rails, the next Canadians. The maple leaf upon our flag, the puppies John McCrae, the silver cup Lord Stanley, and the chalice from Earl Grey. Our snowbird soaring up the sky and Terry on the run. As one we stand, we built this land, we are Canadian. Voyagers in birch bark canoes who braved the wilderness. Men of the Northwest mounted marching out to tame the West. The railroad running underground toward the northern sun. We are the true North, strong and free. We are Canadian. We are bishop in the air, and to keep our country free, we took the ridge called Vimy, came ashore at Normandy. Warriors shedding blood and tears, the ones who did not bend. We lined the hero's highway. We are Canadian. We are our schooner Blue Nose, the poppies John McCrae, the silver cup Lord Stanley, and the chalice from Earl Grey. Our snowbird soaring up the sky and Terry on the run. As one we stand, we built this land, we are Canadian. Roberta Bondi, Clara Hughes, Buffy St. Marie, Viola Desmond on our tent, Lucy Maud Montgomery. The suffragettes who won their fight to vote beside the men. Women standing proud and tall, we are Canadian. We are the broken treaties and the promises not kept. The stains upon our history and the tears still being wept. We are also Gordon Downie, who vowed to make amends. When made aware, we learned to care, we are Canadian. Chris Hadfield's Vista, sea to sea, the poppies John McCrae, silver cup Lord Stanley, and the chalice from Earl Grey. Our snowbird soaring up the sky and Terry on the run. As one we stand, we built this land, we are Canadian. We're all now keepers of the flame, we share this mighty land with those from every place on earth who now beside us stand. We all live on this blessed soil that to death we will defend. Diversified yet unified, we are Canadian. We welcome those who seek our shores, the comers who are new. Every one of us through time from elsewhere came like you. Down the years the message grows, your sons and daughters send. As one we stand, we built this land, we are Canadian. As one we stand, we built this land, we are Canadian. As one we stand, we love this land, we are Canadian.
Thank you, Board Chair Lento. We appreciate your thoughtful words and message. To our graduating students, I am proud that we have been somewhat successful in managing our COVID safety protocols. And because of all of you and taking that care, we are all here together today. Thank you. We've had to overcome many challenges to get to this day, and some of them are related to constraints we've had to endure at school, but there are some other challenges as well. For some of you, these challenges were a result of difficult decisions or a difficult class you needed to pass or simply needing time to figure yourself out. For all of us, these challenges have included coming to school every day, wearing your masks, and going to a separate entrance and having limited course selections, one-way traffic through our halls, and hand sanitizer every step of the way. However, you have all persevered and endured to get to the finish as a graduate here today at Fernie Secondary School. Give yourselves a round of applause. This is a moment to be truly proud of. It is a moment to recognize that there are also many, many people behind you who have supported, encouraged you to be your best. Your parents have loved and cared for you every step of your way to this day. And they are your biggest cheerleaders and your hardest truth tellers. Please take a moment to appreciate all that they have done to get you to this day and celebrate all that you have accomplished. Thank you, parents. You also have many teachers from kindergarten to grade 12 who have taught you and challenged you to learn, to work hard, and to try your best. Those teachers who taught you to read and have number sense in your early years of school created the foundation for your learning here at Fernie Secondary. The superintendent of our school district, Silka Yardley, and the senior management team for our school district have worked hard throughout your school careers to lead our schools and help prepare you all for a successful start to life after high school, for whatever path you choose. You heard the message from your school trustee and board chair, Mr. Frank Lento. He has supported our schools with his insight, guidance, and wisdom. I know that he would have liked to be here in person to share his message with you all well. You have had many layers of support to guide you to this day, and we hope that the lessons you have learned from us and the guidance you have received from us will carry you beyond today and into your future. If there is anything we have learned from our experiences during this past year, it is that patience, perseverance, and resilience are qualities for success. Be patient with yourself as you learn and gain wisdom from your experiences. Persevere, even when you are challenged with a difficult situation. Be resilient. There are times when life will not go your way. Bend when you need to, but remain true to yourself and the direction that you are moving in. Graduates, you've worked very hard to get to this day. I had the opportunity to see the grade 6 celebration outside in the school field. It feels like just a short time ago that you were those same little kids feeling excited and nervous about coming to the big school, but here you are today. We have all watched you grow, mature, and blossom during the 6 years that many of you have attended Fernie Secondary School. Our jobs during your time in high school were to prepare you for your next steps. Some of you will go straight into the workforce following graduation, and some will continue your education in the fall at a college, a university, or a trade school, or in the workforce. Whatever you decide, please know that we are proud of each and every one of you as you transition to the next stage of your life. Congratulations to the graduates of 2021. You have reached this milestone. The future is yours, and we are so excited to see where you go. Be brave, be bold, and believe in yourself. So in a moment, we will begin our ceremony where you will receive your certificates and any scholarships or bursaries that you have been awarded. When your name is called, please come to the stage from the right-hand side here at the stairs. You may remove your mask when you get to the stairs. Then you're going to come to the center of the stage. We put some footprints here for you. You're going to pick, you'll get your certificate from me, and you'll stand and turn to face your audience and stand at the center marker. Ms. Romero and Mr. Willens will share information about you and congratulate you. You will then move your tassel from the right-hand side over to the left, and then Mr. Beatty will take your picture. You will receive your applause, and then you will exit down the stairs where you can put your mask back on. If you have received a school award, Ms. Skeed and Ms. Davies will arrange for another photo at the side of the stage. Then you will move back to your seat. And of course, please maintain your physical distancing at all times. Ms. Romero, our vice principal, and Mr. Willens, our teacher, will begin by calling our graduates in alphabetical order.
Include a demonstrated excellence in the culinary arts and who plans to pursue a career in the hospitality or business field. Congratulations, Eden.
This bursary is awarded to a student whose parents or grandparents are members of the Waldo Stock Breeders Livestock Association. Congratulations, Jada. Rosalie Arcoit. Rosie is a level 2 certified ski instructor and a director on the Fernie Youth Action Network's Girls Leadership Advisory Board. She will be attending the University of Saskatchewan for biomedical neuroscience and wishes to pursue a career in the field of medicine. Rosie's most memorable experience at FSS was Girls Art Night. Rosie is the recipient of 3 Fernie Secondary Academic Awards this year. First, she has been awarded the top English language student. Rosie showed not only a desire to learn and improve on her already excellent critical thinking and writing skills, but also a real love of both reading and writing in English 12. Rosie, secondly, is receiving the top natural science award for her outstanding performance in all aspects of the biology class. Third, Rosie was the top physical science student as she achieved excellent grades in both chemistry and physics 12. Rosie is receiving the 3300 Club Academic Scholarship. This scholarship is awarded to a top academic student in recognition of her commitment and dedication to her studies. She is also receiving the SD5 District Authority Scholarship. This scholarship recognizes students for excellence in their chosen area of interest. Rosie received this scholarship for her presentation on physical activity. Congratulations, Rosie. Riley Barr. Riley's activities include going to the lake, dirt biking, skiing, hiking, or camping with friends. He plans to work for the summer to save up for school. Riley's most memorable experience at FSS is hanging with friends. Riley is the recipient of the Perseverance and Resiliency Award. Riley has demonstrated a commitment to achieving his educational goals and has truly excelled in his grade 12 year. Riley is receiving the Rotary Club of Fernie Trade Scholarship. This award is given to a student who plans to pursue trades training at the post-secondary level and who has shown dedication to his chosen field of study. Congratulations, Riley.
Nicola Bell. Nikki's favorite activities are soccer, skiing, and rock climbing. She is going to the University of Victoria to study political science. Her most memorable experiences at FSS are traveling and playing sports. Nikki is receiving the George Magic Scholarship for the Humanities. Congratulations on receiving the George Magic Scholarship for the Humanities. This scholarship was set up by his eldest child, Kirsten Fear, and her family in honor of him. George embodies countless qualities to be admired, such as humility, kindness, acceptance, and generosity. He was an avid advocate of education, had a thirst for knowledge, and valued hard work immensely. Before attending law school, George studied the humanities at the University of Toronto. He loved history, philosophy, economics, and politics, among other subjects, and would be very proud of your achievements and excited for your journey ahead. Nikki is receiving the Southeast Kootenai Principal and Vice Principal Association Scholarship. This award is given to a son or daughter of a principal or vice principal in the Southeast Kootenai. Congratulations, Nikki. Erica Blackburn Rodriguez. Erica played volleyball and soccer during her high school years. She was very passionate and loved sports and being physically active. Erica was chosen for MVP in volleyball and gives herself an award for being the coolest Latina in Fernie Secondary School. Erica hopes to help adults by teaching Spanish and English in developing nations, including Nicaragua. Helping others is important during this time, and that is her focus. Her most memorable high school experience was in Edmonton, where she got to see amazing performances. Erica also enjoyed traveling for volleyball with her friends. Congratulations, Erica. Elliot Burt. Elliot Elliott is attending post-secondary school for business at either Bishop's University or Mount Royal University. His most memorable experience at FSS is meeting new friends. Elliott also enjoys traveling and playing sports. Elliott is receiving the Elk River Masonic Lodge No. 35 Award. This award is given to a student who has shown dedication to their studies and who plans to pursue post-secondary education. Elliott is receiving the Royal Canadian Legion Scholarship. The recipient of this scholarship has shown dedication to his studies and plans to pursue further training at a post-secondary institution. Congratulations, Elliott.
Samila Carr. In the community, Samila was actively involved in coaching ski racing with the Fernie Alpine Ski Team. Her achievements including attending the BC Games for Alpine Skiing and successfully untying a human knot with her math class. Samila plans to take a gap year, then attend the University of Calgary for Natural Sciences in the fall of 2022. Samila's most memorable experience at FSS is the Glee Club with Mr. Beatty in grade 10. Samila is receiving the East Kootenai Community Credit Union Scholarship, which is awarded to a graduating student who is a member or a dependent of an East Kootenai Community Credit Union member, as well as the Elk River Masonic Lodge No. 35, which is an award given to students who have shown dedication to their studies and who plan to pursue post-secondary education, as well as the Fernie Chamber of Commerce Scholarship. This scholarship is awarded to a student who is pursuing post-secondary education and whose parent is employed by Fernie Chamber of Commerce, as well as the Royal Canadian Legion Scholarship. The recipient of this scholarship has shown dedication to her studies and plans to pursue further training at a post-secondary institution. Congratulations, Samila. Kira Corrigan. Kira has enjoyed being part of the Youth Action Network Girls Leadership Advisory Board. She will be attending the University of Lethbridge in the fall and plans to pursue a career in health sciences. Kira's most memorable experiences are spending her summers at Blue Lake and evenings with friends. Kira is the recipient of the Shop and Industrial Arts Award. She is recognized for her performance, tenacity, and perseverance in her classes this year. She is receiving the Fernie Women's Resource Center Lynn Mace Bursary. This bursary is awarded to a female student who has contributed to her community in a meaningful way, as well as the Dr. Sparling and Mrs. Mary East Scholarship. This award goes to an academic student who plans to pursue a career in the health sciences. Congratulations, Kira. Brooke Demings. Brooke played on the basketball and volleyball teams at the school and plays for the club teams in the community. Brooke is graduating with the dual Dogwood diploma and has received junior and senior girls basketball MVP awards. She is going to the University of Victoria for general science and biology. Her most memorable experience at FSS was playing at Senior Girls Basketball Provincials in Kelowna. Brooke is receiving the Dr. Spencer Roy McLean Memorial Scholarship. This scholarship is given to a top academic student who plans to enter the medical field, as well as the Seniors Drop-In Center Scholarship. This scholarship goes to a top academic student who plans to enter a field that benefits seniors and who has contributed to their community in a meaningful way. Congratulations, Brooke.
Jenna Dyes. Jenna was actively involved in Mountainside Youth Group and played basketball and badminton at Fernie Secondary. Jenna received the Top Distinction Award at Fernie Secondary School since grade 7. In the fall of 2021, Jenna will be attending Miller College in Sunnybrae, BC. She is unsure of what career to pursue, but hopes it will involve helping children. One of Jenna's favorite school memories is when she played Violet in the school's production of Charlie and the Chocolate Factory. Jenna is receiving the Home Economics Award for her stellar performance and leadership throughout her years of participation in the program. Jenna is receiving the United Steel Worker Local 9346 Scholarship. This is given to a dependent of a United Steel Worker Local 9346 member to help the student pursue post-secondary education, as well as the Rotary Club of Fernie. This award is given to a top academic student who has volunteered in the community and who plans to pursue further training at the post-secondary level, as well as the SD5 District Authority Scholarship. This scholarship recognizes students for excellence in their chosen area of interest. Jenna received this scholarship for her presentation on community service. Congratulations, Jenna. Don Dimiakyak. Don played for the school basketball team through his junior and senior years. He is also part of the grad committee this year. He is going to the University of Lethbridge and studying computer science. Don is receiving the Columbia Power Bursary. Columbia Power donates this scholarship to students who have shown a desire to succeed in their studies and who plan to pursue further education at the post-secondary level. Congratulations, Don. Laura Dykusen. At Fernie Secondary, Laura played basketball and was on the track and field team. She is going to Selkirk College in the fall to study forest technology. Her most memorable experience at Fernie Secondary is working in the wood and metal shop. Laura is receiving the Canfor Scholarship. Canfor awards this scholarship to students who plan to pursue further training in a forestry-specific field, as well as the Robert Boyer Memorial Forestry Entrance Scholarship. This scholarship is given by Selkirk College to support students who are entering the Forest Technology Program, as well as the Royal Canadian Legion Bursary. The recipient of this scholarship has shown dedication to her studies, who plans to pursue further training at post-secondary institution and who has a relative with a history of military service, as well as the SD5 District Authority Scholarship. This scholarship recognizes students for excellence in their chosen area of interest. Laura received this scholarship for her presentation on applied skills. Congratulations, Laura.
Austin Ellerby. Yeah! Austin has been a two-year member of the Fernie Secondary Jazz Band. He is a two-time recipient of the Ladifi Award. Austin has been accepted to the University of Calgary and is planning to pursue a career in biological science. His most vivid memory is when he played We Don't Start the Fire by Billy Joel in front of his guitar class in grade 10. Austin is receiving the City of Fernie Scholarship, which is an award given to a deserving student of Fernie Secondary School who is planning to attend a post-secondary school institution, as well as the Elk Valley Society for Community Living. This bursary is awarded to students who have successfully completed their educational goals, as well as the SD5 District Authority Scholarship, which is a scholarship that recognizes students for excellence in their chosen area of interest. Austin received this scholarship for his presentation on fine arts. Congratulations, Austin. Chase Erickson. Chase was a member of the Fernie Secondary Jazz Band for 4 years. Chase has been accepted to the University of Alberta. He plans to complete a Bachelor of Science with a major in biology. Chase's most memorable experience was in school was the band trip to Whistler in 2018. Chase is receiving the Fernie Secondary School Parent Advisory Council Bursary. This award is presented to a deserving student who is graduating from Fernie Secondary School and pursuing further training at a post-secondary institution. Congratulations, Chase. Sydney Fesselt. Sydney played on the volleyball and basketball teams at FSS. She has worked hard and volunteered in the community and in school. Sydney won the Distinction Jaffrey Rebel Volleyball Award and the Bud Buckle Citizenship Award at Jaffrey School. Next year, Sydney will be attending the College of the Rockies to study science and then plans to attend the University of Lethbridge to complete a Bachelor of Education in Math and Science. Her most memorable experience at FSS was getting second place at provincials in volleyball and going to provincials with the basketball team twice. Sydney is receiving the Elk Valley Society for Community Living Bursary, which is awarded to students who have successfully completed their educational goals, as well as the Jolene Ferris Memorial Scholarship. This award is presented in memory of a former student, Jolene Ferris. This award is intended to help the student further their education, as well as the Sand Creek Lions Club Scholarship. This award is given to a student who resides in Elko, Grasmere, Baines Lake, or Jaffrey. The student plans to enroll in full-time post-secondary studies. Congratulations, Sydney.
Kai Fate. Kai is a member of the Fernie Nordic Racers and the Fernie Railyard Dog Park Volunteer Team, as well as being a violinist at the East Kootenay Ensemble. Some of Kai's accomplishments include being awarded the Amy Roberts Memorial Trophy from the Fernie Rod and Gun Club, winning second place at the Tech Kootenay Cup in Rossland for the Fernie Nordic Racers, and being selected to play with the East Kootenay Ensemble at the East Kootenay Performing Arts Festival. Kai will be attending the University of Victoria to study journalism. Kai's most memorable experience at FSS is the social justice class with Ms. Weber. Kai is receiving the Columbia Basin Trust Youth Community Service Award. This scholarship is awarded to a student who has demonstrated extensive community service, as well as the Fernie Rod and Gun Club Scholarship. This scholarship is awarded to a member of the Fernie Rod and Gun Club to support the pursuit of further education. Congratulations, Kai. Easton Fieldhouse. The activities that Easton was involved in were the Fernie Youth Action Network Committee, the Elk Valley Pride Society Board, and the local roller derby team, the Bomb Squad. Easton's plan for the future is to move to Vancouver to study at Blanche McDonald Center to become an esthetician. Her most memorable experience from school was the band trip to Whistler in grade 9 and screaming Bohemian Rhapsody with everyone on the bus. I wish I knew that song so I could understand what it is. Okay, I'm sorry. Easton is receiving the Top Social Studies Award for her outstanding work over the years in the humanities area. Her performance in Law 12 solidified Easton as this year's winner. Congratulations, Easton. Alistair Fife. Alistair's most notable activities were skiing, hiking, fishing, and surfing. Alistair is taking a trip to Australia and Asia for a year, and after his travels, he plans to attend Mount Royal University to study commerce. Alistair's most memorable experiences were hanging out with friends, his skiing career, and the grad run-through. Alistair is receiving the Les Hockley Memorial Firefighters Bursary. This scholarship is awarded to students who are relatives of past or present Fernie firefighters. Congratulations, Alistair.
Brooklyn Graham. Brooklyn was involved with basketball, volleyball, and student council during her years at Jaffrey Secondary School prior to attending Fernie Secondary School. She has achieved many academic and athletic awards during her school years. Brooklyn plans to attend the College of the Rockies in the fall. Brooklyn's most memorable experience at FSS was when her class went to Spain and Morocco. Jaffrey. Brooklyn is receiving the 3300 Club Dr. Roy McLean Scholarship. This award is given to a student who has shown dedication and commitment to their chosen field. In addition, the student is a leader who has dedicated time to community service, as well as the College of the Rockies Entrance Scholarship. This award is given by the College of the Rockies to recognize academic efforts and to help students with the cost of tuition. Congratulations, Brooklyn. Brooke Greenwood. Throughout Brooke's high school experience, she played volleyball for her school team, the Fernie Falcons, as well as her community's club team, the Fernie Phantoms. Brooke was part of the FSS senior volleyball team that placed second at provincials. Brooke is also a diehard Save Honor. Special shout out to Jen, Mitch, and Michelle. Brooke will be continuing her studies at the University of Lethbridge, working towards a degree in environmental science. Brooke's most memorable experience in high school is playing volleyball with her peers, especially during her senior year of club and school. Brooke is receiving the Western Communities Foundational Exceptional Achievement and Bursary Award. This scholarship is awarded to a student who is seeking further training or education to become a productive citizen and who has overcome adversity, has displayed outstanding community or school spirit, and has demonstrated inspirational conduct in a crisis. Congratulations, Brooke. Good work. Isabella Gouliash. Isabella was involved in many school sports, including soccer and badminton. Isabella is happy to have completed her graduation requirements early. She enjoys participating in competitions, and in her future plans, they include traveling outside of Canada. Congratulations, Brooke. Congratulations, Isabella. Sorry.
Jack Halley. Jack plans to travel across Canada and pursue a career that involves chemistry. His most memorable experience during high school is legendary parties with the boys. Jack is receiving the Isabella Dickin Pack Bursary. This bursary is awarded to a deserving student who attended Isabella Dickin Elementary School. Congratulations, Jack. Braden Helgren. Braden is a trombone player in the jazz band, and he, in his free time, he enjoys skiing and creating video games. Braden will be attending the University of Victoria to study computer science. Braden plans to pursue a career as a software developer. Braden loves the ocean, and one of his favorite memories was scuba diving. He hopes to become a certified diver once he can travel again. Braden is receiving the East Kootenay District Labor Council Bursary. This scholarship is awarded to a student who is planning to attend a post-secondary institution and who has a family member affiliated with the East Kootenay Labor Council, as well as the Rocky Mountain Optometry Scholarship. This scholarship is awarded to a student who is continuing their education at a post-secondary institution and who has excelled in senior sciences, as well as the SD5 District Authority Scholarship. This scholarship recognizes students for excellence in their chosen area of interest. Braden received this scholarship for his presentation on applied skills. Congratulations, Braden. Ella Hofer. Ella is interested in pursuing a career in addictions counseling. Ella's most memorable experiences were school sports trips and spending time with friends. Ella is receiving the Fernie Secondary School Parent Advisory Council Bursary. This award is presented to a deserving student of Fernie Secondary School who is planning to attend a post-secondary school. Congratulations, Ella.
Jaden Home Richards. Jaden played volleyball and basketball on club teams and on school teams. She also participated in dance for many years before and during high school. Jaden received honors with distinction throughout high school and was part of BC's Principal List program. She plans to take a gap year and then attend university to study criminal law. Playing sports and dancing were Jaden's highlights in school, as well as meeting many amazing teachers, new friends, coaches, instructors, and reconnecting with family and friends. Congratulations, Jaden. Indica House. Indica is planning on traveling to Australia for a year to explore new career choices and gain life experience. Her most memorable experience is going on adventures with friends. Congratulations, Indica. Justin Hula. Justin likes to hunt, fish, hang out with friends. He has received awards through the Fernie Rod and Gun Club. Justin would like to take some time off from school to figure out what his future plans are. His most memorable experiences are hanging out with friends. Congratulations, Justin.
Bo Hutchinson. Bo likes snowmobiling, dirt biking, and archery. Over the years, Bo has received archery awards and many hockey awards. After graduation, Bo plans to study heavy-duty mechanics. His most memorable life experience is logging with his dad when he was a kid. Bo is receiving the Garrett and Fernie Ready Mix Scholarship. This scholarship is awarded to a student who intends to pursue post-secondary training in the mechanical trade. Congratulations, Bo. Cole Hutchinson. Cole is going to Concordia University for a major in anthropology and a minor in law. Cole's most memorable experience at FSS is spending time with his friends. Cole is receiving the Fernie Secondary School Scholarship. This scholarship is awarded to deserving students of Fernie Secondary who have shown dedication to achieving their educational goals. Congratulations, Cole. Emerson Impey. Emerson has been accepted to the University of Lethbridge to pursue a dual degree in art and education with a major in history. After completing a dual bachelor degree, Emerson plans to complete a master's degree. Her most memorable experiences as a new student at Fernie Secondary School was being made to feel welcome by students and teachers. Emerson is receiving one of the 2021 Fernie Secondary Art Awards for her creativity and top performance in our art program this year. She is also receiving the Charles Jason Roa Memorial Scholarship. This scholarship is presented in memory of Charles Jason Roa. The scholarship is awarded to a student who has succeeded in Art 12 and who makes a positive contribution to creating an inclusive culture at Fernie Secondary School. Congratulations, Emerson.
Ashley Jones. Ashley's activities are archery, basketball in grades 7 to 10, and volleyball in grades 7 and 8. She plans to take a gap year, spend time traveling, and then go to college. Ashley's most memorable experiences in high school were definitely Miss Adams' food class and spending time in Amanda's cool room relaxing. Congratulations, Ashley. Holly Kishler. Holly plans to attend post-secondary school to study psychology. Her most memorable moment in school was going to Whistler for Band in grade 9. Holly is the recipient of the Lorena Moco Memorial Scholarship. This award is donated by Mr. Robert Paulson and is dedicated to the memory of Lorena Moco. Congratulations, Holly. Tatum Kipnick. Tatum has been a competitive swimmer for the Elk Valley Dolphins for 8 years and has also been a junior coach for 2 years. Tatum has continuously broken times throughout her swimming career and has been awarded Swimmer of the Year. Tatum is also a Montana State champion, Manitoba, Saskatchewan Provincial, and BC Provincial qualifier. She will be attending the University of Lethbridge this fall, where she will achieve her lifelong goal of becoming an elementary school teacher. Tatum's most memorable experiences are the opportunities she's had during the past year meeting and talking to varsity coaches in the U.S. of A. She is receiving the East Kootenai Community Credit Union Scholarship, which is awarded to a student graduating who is a member or a dependent of an East Kootenai Community Credit Union member, as well as the Diane Durek Memorial Scholarship. This scholarship is awarded to a student who plans to pursue further education in the human service field. Congratulations, Tatum.
Ronan LaFortune. During his time at Fernie Secondary, Ronan enjoyed hanging out with his friends and playing in the band Lux. Congratulations, Ronan. Dazrin Larkin. Dazrin's activities are skateboarding, art, and basketball. He placed first choice in Best Trick at Cranbrook Skateboarding Choice Competition, fourth place at Valley Rally Video Competition, and was MIP for basketball. His future plans are anything skateboard related, building boards, parks, and teaching young skaters. Dazrin's most memorable experience was the grade 9 band trip to Whistler. Congratulations, Dazrin. Autumn Lightburn. Autumn plans to attend the College of the Rockies and then plans to travel to cool places. Her most memorable moments are summer and hanging with good friends. Autumn is receiving the Sand Creek Lady Lion Scholarship. This scholarship is given to a student who lives in the South Country, is enrolled in academic courses, and who attended grade 10 at Jaffrey Junior Secondary School, as well as the Triangle Women's Institute Bursary. This scholarship is presented to a South Country student who has been actively involved in the community. Congratulations, Autumn.
Okay. Nesta Malcolm. Nesta played basketball and was also part of the band Lux. He was measured in at 6'7 by myself and won MVP for basketball a few times. Nesta is attending Okanagan College to play basketball and study music production. His most memorable experiences were in his grade nine energy project and his mom, Tanya, yelling at him during basketball games. Nesta Malcolm is the recipient of this year's Physical Education Award. He is one of our top physical education students and has excelled in the subject during his time at Fernie Secondary. Nesta is the recipient of the QP Local 2093 Bursary. This bursary is given to the child of a QP 2093 member to help the student pursue further education, as well as the Fernie Secondary School Athletic Bursary. This award is given to a grade 12 student who has shown dedication and commitment to their chosen sport. Nesta is our chosen recipient for this award because he has excelled in basketball whilst maintaining excellent grades. He has also demonstrated leadership, skills, and shown respect to his teammates and competitors. As well, he is receiving the Elk River Masonic Lodge number 35. This award is given to students who have shown dedication to their studies and who plan to pursue post-secondary education. As well, the Fernie Elks Lodge number 81 scholarship. This scholarship is given to a graduating student who has demonstrated leadership and community spirit. This recipient knows the value of volunteering and has dedicated time to serving the community. And lastly, the SD5 District Authority Scholarship. This scholarship recognizes students for excellence in their chosen area of interest. Nesta received this scholarship for his presentation on fine arts. Congratulations, Nesta. Sienna McCall. Sienna was involved in volleyball and student council. She received MVP for volleyball in grade 5 and was a member of the FSS volleyball team that placed second at provincials. Sienna is attending the College of the Rockies for pre-education, then plans to attend the University of Victoria to complete a Bachelor of Education. Sienna's most memorable experience was hanging out at the ledge with friends. Sienna is receiving the Elk Valley Thrift Store Scholarship. This award is given to a student who has dedicated time to volunteering at the Elk Valley Thrift Store and who plans to pursue further education at a post-secondary institution. Congratulations, Sienna. Ethan McCray. Ethan DJed for multiple events in the school and community. Ethan enjoyed chilling with his friends and getting the chance to party till he dropped. His greatest accomplishment is meeting Macklemore's nephew. Congratulations, Ethan.
Annalise Nelson. Annalise played volleyball for the Fernie Secondary team in grade 11. She is attending the College of the Rockies this fall for the pre-education program. Annalise's most memorable experience was traveling in Thailand for a month in grade 11. Annalise is receiving the Fernie Secondary School Scholarship. This scholarship is awarded to deserving students of Fernie Secondary who have shown dedication to achieving their educational goals. Congratulations, Annalise. Micah Neufeld. Micah has completed his Avalanche Safety Training 1 course at Fernie Secondary. Micah has yet to receive an award in school, but he did unofficially win the award for holding his breath the longest in 2010. His plans for the near future are to chill hard with the boys and play more golf. Micah's most memorable moment is making a full court shot in the gym. No one saw, but he claims it still happened. Congratulations, Micah. Alexandra Perverzov. Alexandra has been a part of the school volleyball team since grade 5, as well as a part of the Fernie Volleyball Club since 2017. She has completed the French immersion program and will be graduating bilingual with the dual dogwood. Alexandra will be attending the University of Victoria in the fall of 2021 to take financial mathematics and economics. Her most memorable experiences are going to the lake with the girls in the summer and playing volleyball. Alex is the recipient of our Top Math Student Award. She is recognized for her impressive performance in mathematics at Fernie Secondary this year. She is an athlete. She's a mathlete. We're not done. Alex is also receiving the Fernie Chamber of Commerce Youth Achievement Award. This award is given to Alexandra in recognition of her accomplishments during her time at Fernie Secondary School. Alex is one of our top academic students. She will graduate with a bilingual diploma in English and French. Alex is a talented athlete who has played on both our basketball and our volleyball teams. In addition to maintaining excellent grades and participating in sports, Alex has also volunteered extensively in our community. She has volunteered at Rocky Mountain Village, Fernie Heritage Library, and the Salvation Army. And she has also helped to build the bike trails. Most recently, Alex baked for frontline workers during COVID and also helped to deliver groceries to seniors. Alex is a very well-rounded student who is an asset to our school and community. She is a very deserving candidate for the award. Alex is also receiving the Columbia Basin Trust Youth Community Service Award. This scholarship is awarded to a student who has demonstrated extensive community service, as well as the Harry Barma Scholarship. The Harry Barma Scholarship is given to the top academic student at Fernie Secondary School. Harry Barma was a very successful businessman. He brought the first Subway restaurant to Fernie in December 1991. He was also the owner and operator of the Three Sisters Motel. Harry's three sons graduated from Fernie Secondary and are now well settled in Calgary. Finally, Alex is also receiving the Sarah Wetham Memorial Scholarship. This scholarship is awarded to a female student in School District 5 who has received the highest mark on the Euclid exam and who plans to continue her studies in the STEM field. Congratulations, Alex.
Zachary Perot. Zach plays and coaches hockey, coaches tennis, and plays basketball. He plans to go to post-secondary school for education and live in Japan. Zach's most memorable moment is skateboarding and hanging with friends. Zach is receiving the East Kootenai Community Credit Union bursary, which is awarded to a graduating student who is a member or a dependent of an East Kootenai Community Credit Union member, as well as the Fernie Secondary School Kitchen Crew Award. This scholarship is presented to Zach in recognition of his contribution to our school cafeteria. He demonstrated excellent work habits and a positive attitude. Congratulations, Zach. Mac Piney. Mac has been part of the Fernie Secondary School track and field team, volunteers at Fernie Search and Rescue, and helps with the Fernie Secondary School AV equipment. Mac is attending Mount Royal to study computer information systems. Mac's most memorable experience was volleyball provincials with the boys. Mac is receiving the Positive Contribution Award. This award is given to a student who has made a meaningful contribution to staff and students of Fernie Secondary. Mac has not only been a positive presence in the classroom, but has used his technological skills to help the wider school community. Mac is receiving the Fernie Secondary School Technology Award. This scholarship is awarded to Mac in recognition of the technological support that he has given to staff and students at Fernie Secondary. He is always willing to answer questions, make meaningful suggestions, and give up his free time to ensure our technology is running smoothly. His help has been much appreciated during his time at Fernie Secondary. Congratulations, Mac. Sierra Pomerantz. Sierra has played volleyball throughout high school for the Fernie Secondary team and for the Fernie Volleyball Club. Sierra played on the Fernie Secondary Senior Girls Volleyball team that placed second at Provincials. Sierra helped regularly in the student resource room and is graduating with a dual dogwood. Sierra is also aspiring to become the ultimate Starbucks barista. Sierra will be attending the University of British Columbia to complete a Bachelor of Arts. She hopes to continue her education to become a speech and language pathologist. Sierra's most memorable experiences are her opportunities to play at the provincials and be on a team with people she loves. Sierra is receiving the Canadian Parents for French Award. This scholarship is awarded to a French immersion student who has shown commitment to the French language and who will graduate with a bilingual dogwood diploma. As well, she is receiving the City of Fernie Academic Scholarship. This award is given to a high-achieving student of Fernie Secondary School who is planning to attend a post-secondary institution. As well, the Fernie Elks Lodge No. 81 Scholarship. This scholarship is given to a graduating student who has demonstrated leadership and community spirit. The recipient knows the value of volunteering and has dedicated time to serving the community. And lastly, Sierra is receiving the SD5 District Authority Scholarship. This scholarship recognizes students for their excellence in their chosen area of interest. Sierra received this scholarship for her presentation on community service. Congratulations, Sierra.
Owen Rankin. Owen loves playing basketball with the boys and skateboarding. Owen won MVP for basketball at East Kootenays in grade 10. He is moving to Toronto to be an iron worker with his dad. Owen's most memorable experiences are floating the river and cliff jumping. Owen is the recipient of the Fernie Secondary School Scholarship. This scholarship is awarded to deserving students of Fernie Secondary who have shown dedication to achieving their educational goals. Congratulations, Owen. Jaden Rumpel. Jaden was a part of the Youth Action Network Board and did a variety of workshops teaching children how to dance. She also performed in many community dance shows. Jaden is taking a gap year to work, travel, and take a few aesthetics courses. She plans to attend university next year. Jaden's most memorable experience is hanging out in Mr. Willen's class, listening to music, and working with friends. Congratulations, Jaden. Gabby Rybar. Gabby will be attending the University of Calgary to study dance. She plans to explore a career in choreography and creative writing. Her most memorable experiences are the time she spent with her friends and the places she has traveled with her family. Gabby is the recipient of one of the Fernie Secondary Art Awards for her impressive work in the art education program over the years, as well as the George Magic Scholarship for the Humanities. The George Magic Scholarship was set up by his eldest child, Kirsten Feer, and her family in honor of him. George embodies countless qualities to be admired, such as humility, kindness, acceptance, and generosity. He was an avid advocate of education, had a thirst for knowledge, and valued hard work immensely. Before attending law school, George studied the humanities at the University of Toronto. He loved history, philosophy, economics, and politics, among other subjects, and would be very proud of your achievements and excited for your journey ahead. Congratulations, Gabby.
Liam Samicia. Liam is an athlete. He loves to play hockey, soccer, lacrosse, and almost anything else. Liam plans to take a gap year to play on the Fernie Ghost Riders hockey team for another season. Liam would like to pursue a business degree and complete the real estate certification program. Some of Liam's most memorable experiences include traveling for hockey to Colorado Springs, Blaine, Minnesota, Detroit, Michigan, and Whitehorse, Yukon. Congratulations, Liam. Dylan Sarabun. Dylan's activities include hunting, biking, and working on vehicles. He has received awards through the Rod and Gun Club. Dylan plans to become a welder or heavy-duty mechanic. His most memorable experience was hanging out with friends. Congratulations, Dylan. Rebecca Schmidt. Rebecca's plans for the future include taking training to become an advocate for youth who need support through their teen years. Rebecca's accomplishments include a comprehensive capstone project about youth and the need for supports for teens who struggle with their mental health. Her favorite memory is spending time in the Aboriginal welcoming space whenever she needed it. Congratulations, Rebecca.
Declan Shaw. Declan has been involved in the Air Cadet program since 2015. As an Air Cadet, Declan received his Long Service Medal in 2020 and achieved the rank of Flight Sergeant. Declan is exploring options in trades and technology. His most memorable experience is learning to drive and also attending cadet summer camps. Declan is receiving the Royal Canadian Legion bursary. The recipient of this bursary has shown dedication to their studies and plans to pursue further training at a post-secondary institution, and has a relative with a history of military service. Congratulations, Declan. Lauren Sims. Throughout high school, Lauren has played for Fernie Secondary Volleyball Team, as well as for the Fernie Volleyball Club. Lauren was a member of the Fernie Secondary Volleyball Team that placed second at the Senior Girls Provincials in 2020. She also commits time to coaching younger age groups. Lauren will be graduating with her Dual Dogwood Diploma and will be attending the University of Victoria in the fall to pursue a bachelor's degree in commerce. Lauren's most memorable experience at Fernie Secondary was traveling to Nanaimo to compete in the Senior Girls Provincials in 2018. Lauren is receiving the Art Robinson Memorial Bursary. This bursary is awarded to a student who demonstrated a commitment to community volunteerism, as well as the East Kootenay Community Credit Union. This scholarship is awarded to a graduating student who is a member or a dependent of an East Kootenay Community Credit Union member, as well as the JABC and CBT Basin Impact Award. This award recognizes a student from the Columbia Basin who has demonstrated how a JA program significantly improved their work readiness skills and positively impacted their future. And finally, Lauren is the recipient of the School District 5 District Authority Scholarship. This scholarship recognizes students for excellence in their chosen area of interest. Lauren received this scholarship for her presentation on applied skills. Congratulations, Lauren. Bailey Smith. Bailey has been accepted to the University of Victoria to complete a Bachelor of Psychology. She then plans to attend law school, also at the University of Victoria. Bailey's most memorable experience in school was Glee Club with Samila and Mr. Beatty. Another memorable moment for Bailey was being a TA for Miss Elliott. Bailey is receiving the Fernie Secondary School Scholarship. This scholarship is awarded to deserving students of Fernie Secondary who have shown dedication to achieving their educational goals. Congratulations, Bailey.
Holly Stevens. Holly's most memorable activities were working in the kitchen with Christy and making food and treats for the students. She plans on taking a gap year before pursuing a career in massage therapy or a trade. Holly's most memorable experience was being in the art room and doing what she enjoyed and being able to make new friendships that will last a lifetime. Holly is the recipient of the Isabella Dickin PAC Bursary. This bursary is awarded to a deserving student who attended Isabella Dickin Elementary School. Congratulations, Holly. Clara Travers. Clara's activities with the school are playing volleyball, winning EKs in grade 10, and coaching volleyball. Clara is graduating a year early from high school and is attending cosmetology school in Calgary. In the future, she hopes to open her own salon. Her most memorable experience in high school is playing volleyball and chilling with the homies on the ledge in Trainer Hall. Clara is the recipient of the 3300 Club Trades and Technical Scholarship. This scholarship is awarded to a student who plans to complete trades training at a post-secondary institution, as well as the City of Fernie Trades Scholarship. This scholarship is awarded to a deserving student of Fernie Secondary School who is planning to attend post-secondary to obtain a trades certificate. As well, the Elk Valley Society for Community Living. This bursary is awarded to students who have successfully completed their educational goals. And lastly, she is the recipient of the Royal Canadian Legion Scholarship. This is for a recipient who has dedicated much time to her studies and plans to pursue further training at a post-secondary institution. Congratulations, Clara. Cameron Wall. Cameron's activities are skiing, basketball, and volleyball. His near future includes winning the day and chasing his dreams. Cam's most memorable experiences are eating food in class and spending time with his friends. Cam is receiving the QP Local 4165 Bursary. This scholarship is awarded in memory of Tucker Barris. The recipient of this scholarship is the dependent of an active member of QP Local 4165. He is also receiving the SD5 District Authority Scholarship. This scholarship recognizes students for excellence in their chosen area of interest. Cam received this scholarship for his presentation on fine arts. Congratulations, Cameron.
Kale Wenslaw. Kale received his Avalanche Safety Training 1 certificate through Fernie Secondary. His future plans are to take a gap year and to find out what he wants to study at post-secondary school. Congratulations, Kale. Connor Will. Connor has been dedicated to basketball and volleyball, as well as coaching and refereeing for the school. Connor is going to post-secondary school to study history and education, with hopes of becoming a high school teacher. His favorite part of high school was the friendships he built. Connor is the 2021 recipient of the Fernie Secondary Top French Student Award. He is receiving the George Magic Scholarship for the Humanities, as well as the SD5 District Authority Scholarship. This scholarship recognizes the students for excellence in their chosen area of interest. Connor received this scholarship for his presentation on community service. Finally, Connor is receiving the Tech Courageous Leadership Scholarship. This scholarship is awarded to a student who has demonstrated the qualities of a courageous leader. Congratulations, Connor. Andorra Wright. Andorra's greatest achievement was toasting the best spaghetti. She plans to explore the world and ski wherever she can. Andorra's favorite time in school was cooking with Christy. Congratulations, Andorra.
Congratulations to all of you. So thank you, Ms. Romero and Mr. Willens. So I'd like to take a moment to extend our appreciation to our community for their generous support of our graduates. Because of their generous support, we have been able to provide a total of 76,975 in scholarships, bursaries, and awards to all of you. Let's give our community a big round of applause. I would like to call Alexandra Perverzov to the stage. I will be presenting Alex with the Governor General's Academic Award. The Governor General's Medal, established in 1873, recognizes students who have achieved the highest academic average. On behalf of the Governor General of Canada, I am pleased to extend this award to Ms. Alexandra Perverzov. Congratulations. Next, I would like to call upon the valedictorian for the Fernie Secondary graduating class of 2021, Mr. Connor Will.
Good morning, everyone. I'd like to start by welcoming all grads, our school staff, Ms. Hay and Ms. Romero, and any family or friends watching from home. I would also like to acknowledge that we are grateful to be gathered here on the homeland of the Tanana Nation. I am honored and humbled to be representing this year's graduating class. We were lucky enough to experience our senior year in person, and although our experience may be far different from those of previous graduating classes, I would say that we easily made the most of it. On behalf of the graduating class, I would like to thank everyone who made this year as special as it was. To the teachers who worked tirelessly to ensure that our experience was as close to as normal as possible. To our administration who helped cool situations even when it looked like it may be heading towards disaster, which this year seemed to happen about every once a month. To any secretaries, EAs, to Ms. Bax and Ms. Amanda, and to everyone else who had to adjust their daily routines to accommodate us. From parents and family members to any single one of us in this class and the rest of the school, to janitors and bus drivers, each of your effort, even if it seems futile, helped create the illusion of normal that we all desperately needed this year. Throughout the years, our class has not had the most flattering reputation. From probably being public enemy number one during our grade 6 year at Isabella Dickin, to having half of our grade being involved in an academic scandal, apologies to Madame Danielle, we never have been able to escape our own image. Yet, we have grown into our own people, as unique and diverse as we are. As a class, we have achieved highly, academically, athletically, and we have served our community great. Though many of us missed on what we loved doing most due to the COVID pandemic, it is also important to realize what we have received from the pandemic as well. We have drifted from some and connected with others, lost ourselves just to discover new ones. Many of our different paths and avenues were cut off, redirected, or destroyed altogether. But that doesn't mean that there is no way out. For lots of us, we have already found our new path. For others, you may still feel lost. Just remember to keep searching and to keep moving forward. You will find your path eventually, although it is a burden to know, sometimes you have to close a door to open a window. Many of us may feel regret in life. It can feel daunting. A missed opportunity, a blown chance, or perhaps never getting the comfort or closure we wanted. Life is often unfair. It is cruel and relentless. We have and we will continue to fight battle after battle with ourselves, our lives, and the universe at large. In a place so grand, it is easy to feel lost. Some people search their entire lives for peace, for their purpose, or the true meaning of happiness. You'll have people try and tell you what it is and what is wrong, and you'll have people try and force you to take a certain path. Some say that it is futile to try and find life meaning at all, but I disagree. Remember that it is okay to feel lost and to experience a setback. In the absurdity of the universe, all we can do is embrace the chaos. Don't try to make sense of it. If you do, you will only go mad looking for the answers. Bad things will happen to good people. You may never get the closure you want. You get out of life what you put into it. Your own interpretation of what life's purpose is, what true happiness is valid, and you should never stop pursuing it. You are the universe trying to figure itself out. It is okay to feel down sometimes. It is okay to look into the sky and see nothing but a hopeless void, because let's face it, that's all it could be. But remember, that may be the most uplifting thing of all. Life is your self-portrait. It is not for the gaze of anyone else. It is for you and you alone. Life is your canvas, and every step you have taken, you have been painting it along the way. There will be missteps. There will be times you fall. There will be imperfections. Nonetheless, the image you created is you. Beautiful and strong. When you lie moments from departure, that image will be what you see, and regardless of its imperfections, it will still be art. Some people will rush to fill their canvas, but remember that time is precious. As we get older, time speeds up. As we made our way through high school, days have bled into weeks, weeks into months, months into years. And embedding for most of us, it feels like a blur from the first time we stepped through the front doors on our first day of school in grade 7. As time's arrow marches forward, it can be easy to feel lost in its momentum. Remember to take a chance to slow down. I know our parents have been telling us this to us for years. Our words, the bonds we made, our connection to the world, will fade. A million years from now, we will not be remembered. But your impact is forever. It is terrifying to realize that your memory will be forgotten. But your impact will leave an irreversible mark on the universe. It will ripple and affect the rest of time. Whether or not you realize it, you matter. You may not be remembered for your name, but you will always live on through what you achieve. Time's arrow will continue to march forward, but whether you move forward with it is up to you. Express yourself. Make that crazy choice you've been hung up on for months. Live to the fullest. In the end, it will all fade with time anyways. A thing isn't special because it lasts. It's beautiful because it happened. Now that I'm done boring you with nihilism, I ask that you may please tune back in to wish all you guys my best wishes. No matter what you have or will experience, I know that we are all going to go on and accomplish great things in our lives. I could not have asked for a better group of people to share my childhood with. Growing into a young adult with you guys has been an amazing experience, and I wish the best to each and every one of you in this room. I wouldn't have changed a single thing. Congratulations to everyone in this room. Congratulations to the class of 2021.
Thank you, Connor. I have one more small task to do before we bring our ceremony to a close. I would like to extend a special birthday wish to Miss Sierra Pomerantz. It's her birthday today. So I do want to thank you all for your patience and perseverance while we planned and revised this day many times over. I'm thrilled we are here to honor each and every one of you, and I know it's not the big ceremony you're used to, but I really feel honored to have a smaller ceremony where we get to see each of you, and we really, really do appreciate it. So please give an applause. When I dismiss you, for your final time here at Fernie Secondary School, you will exit toward the back door and back into Trainer Hall. You'll walk back down towards Trainer Hall for the last time as a Fernie Secondary student. Then you'll take off your gown and your white V. You'll have your name checked off. They're in sections of the alphabet, and you'll exit through the doors of Trainer Hall. And in a moment, before we head down that hall, I'll ask you to stand and prepare for your celebratory cap toss. So Mr. Beatty, please come to the stage.
I can get more from this angle.
Okay. So once I ask you to stand and once I say congratulations, that's gonna be your indication to toss your cap and then slowly make your way through Trainer Hall. So please stand. And congratulations to the class of 2021. And